Hi there, my name is Heap, and today I will serve you this. HiFive Unmatched. They say it's the world's most powerful RISC-V development board. We will have a first look, unbox it, and have some thoughts of what's up with this new shenanigan. I have to say, I love the packaging. Look at the box. It's got just clean HiFive Unmatched logo, nothing else. It's clean. Clean. Legit. Yeah. Then inside, you've got a few things. You've got an SD card with a QR code. You've got some motherboard standoffs. Not that you need them. You've got some screws. Some like for M-Tog. To you. You've got an IO shield, which is not the nicest, but I mean, it will do. And you've got the HiFive Unmatched itself, with of course some stuff below. A cable, which the way I hear it, you can use it for debugging. I looked in the data sheet. And you've got a really nice Ethernet cable. What is it? Cat 5e, but like this plug. This here strikes quality. And like this packaging is really nice. I like it. But the star of the show is the unmatched board. We will do the usual thing. I will discharge myself. And here we go. So, I've already opened it beforehand. I just was busy with sea glue, but this is the board. This is the board. Beautiful, isn't it? It's like very tiny. Just look, what a tiny fan here. This fan right here cools down the world's most powerful RISC-V core, which is right below. You've got lots of RAM right here, 16 gigs to be precise. I was supposed to be shipped with 4 when I ordered it, but they upgraded it for 4 more. I love it, not gonna lie. You've got this slot for a battery. We've got a usual 24 pin connector. You've got lots of GPIO stuff, which is very fun. And yes, you've got PCIe slots. You've got the regular 16X. You've got a full-sized M.2 and you've got a tiny one M.2, which is for Wi-Fi cards and stuff, or other things, if you know my channel. And this here, I think, is the PCIe controller, like, or something like that, or is this a memory controller? It can't be memory controller, it's on the other side, so it's gotta be the PCIe controller. What other things do we have here? We've got some IO right here. We've got 4 USB 3 ports, a gigabit, I suppose gigabit, I would assume it's gigabit. You've got a micro SD card slot, and this is the serial debug port. It's very fancy to have it on the board. I mean, this is for development, so I was thinking, so like, here's the thing, I got it because I want to learn assembly finally. Like, I know a bit, I know how to read it, kind of, throughout my years of reverse engineering, but I don't really know, like, I couldn't call myself any skilled whatsoever. Like, I know basic stuff like move, jump, call, return, compare, add. All the basic stuff, but if I were to look at more complex instructions, I don't know a thing. I don't know that. So having this board is really nice because you've got a sane microarchitecture. It's a RISC architecture, specifically RISC-V. It's a 64-bit architecture. It runs Linux. It's pretty powerful. It can run a GPU, which we will put on there. The question is, what GPU, but we'll figure that later. And yeah, this was it. In the next video, we will take this board and put it in a fully fledged rig.
It's going to have lots of surprises along the way, so have your seatbelts ready and be subscribed not to miss it. And if you liked the video, overflow the like button because it helps the channel absolutely tremendously. And don't forget, my name was Heap, yours was undefined. See ya.